The fly that we're going to tie now represents a little rainbow trout. It's a food that's normally found in most of the rivers we fish in. The Esopus Creek that I fish in is loaded with these little guys. They're in the Delaware system here. They're all over the country, as a matter of fact. And many of the larger fish consume these little rainbow lures. For materials, we're going to be using a white bucktail. We're going to have a green bucktail, a pink bucktail, and some brown bucktail. All of these different colors will go into this. So let's start now. We're going to wrap this thread on the hook as we normally do. And the first thing we're going to put in here will be the tail, which is going to be green. Just get a little piece of this. We don't have to really even this up. We're just going to pull some of the shorter fibers out of here, which make it very bulky. We'll tie that in. Like that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to just cut this off right here. Make a little green tail. Now we'll wind forward. Just build this body up slightly. Wind back here. Again, remember, it doesn't make any difference about the amount of thread that we have on here. All it does is add weight to it, and weight is fine. The next thing we're going to put on here is going to be some silver tinsel that will be used for ribbing. Put that underneath. Bring that up over the top and secure that in. Now, what we're going to use here is dubbing. We have to build a pinkish, whitish color body on this. So we're going to tie this forward. I'm going to stretch it out a little bit here. And then we secure it in, secure the dubbing in. Once I secure it in like that, I can wrap it tightly just by twisting it around just like that, and I keep twisting it as I move forward with it. Okay, now we're going to wrap this tinsel on here. That was easy, and just tie it off. Now what we're going to do is tie in some white bucktail on top. We're going to try and make this so it's even. So we'll use our little hair stacker again. Get this extra material out of here. Get that down inside. There you can see it's evened that up a little bit. And again, what we're going to do is just extend this just past the tail, like that. Next, what we're going to use is pink. Now, sometimes I use this pink. Sometimes I use what is known as a hot pink. It's much brighter, but I think today we're going to use just this regular pink material. That looks pretty good. We'll just just tighten that up a little bit. Cut a little bit of brown out of here. But just getting comfortable with using the material is what's supposed to be the most important thing. Now we're just going to stretch this out. Here you can see I just made that slightly short, but we're going to just take this off. That's another fun thing about tying flies. Once you get used to doing it, you can go back and make little corrections. There we go. Now I'll just trim this off of here. Let's just wind this forward from right here. Here's one. Here's another one. And these will go on either side. They call them cheeks. Just make sure they're about the same length. And then we'll take the material off here. We have to, that little one white section right here, we have to get right up close to that. Then what we'll do is I'm just going to turn this around here, put that in there, and tie over the top of this and secure it. Actually, we're just going to back this up. I'm going to angle that up just slightly. There we go. We'll cut this little stem off here. Now we'll put one on this side. Just angle that up a little bit. I'm going to flip this around, take a look at it. They match up pretty well. Cut this stem off. Now, one of the things that you notice when you tie streamers is that the heads of the fly will vary. When we do dry flies and wet flies or nymphs, we don't have nearly as many materials on the fly. So what will happen with a streamer is the more you put on it, the more the head will become bulkier in size. I have just one other little thing to do here, and that is we have to put a little bit of pink right down at the throat of this fly. We'll just use our little stacker again. We're just going to turn this right on over. And do this with it. Okay. And bring that there. And this is our last material that we add onto this fly. Let's see how it looks over here. Now what we're going to do is cover up this pink with more thread. The one thing you can do here is you can always substitute other things. If you have another pink material besides bucktail, which is finer in size and diameter. It will be less bulky. You can use that if you want to. Or you can use the bucktail. I prefer to use the bucktail. That looks pretty good. Now, my little half-inch tool. You can spend, what's interesting, you can spend money on tools. And this little half-inch tool, you can go out and buy one. Here's one here that costs some money, and it was lost for a while. So what I did is I just took this old Parker pen, took the front end of it off, and substituted that. You can always substitute things even with tools, or to some extent you can do that. Now we'll just find my things are lost here. My half or my, oh, there it is, hiding under the material. This is very similar to my own fly tying desk. Things get lost right in front of you all the time. Part of fly tying, I think. The challenge of finding things that we're using not even 2 minutes ago. Put some head cement on here. I really like this fly and a lot. And one of the things I do is I tie flies for people that are like a brooch or a pin that you can put on. And because of the color of this fly, I enjoy doing that as a gift, giving to people. It's a lot of fun. It's very pretty, and people love little rainbows. And this is the little rainbow trout. It's a great fly to use out on the river. And again, you can use this fly in the Catskills. We have lots of rainbows in the Catskills, but you can use it anywhere that rainbows inhabit the rivers.